Hi guys, welcome to Sister Somebody. Today we're going to talk about a really good topic someone asked me to talk about. It is pressure to get married as a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Some of us feel more pressure than others and some of us don't even notice, but I know all of us have been in the position to where we could feel pressure. For example, a mission president asking about marriage so soon, or a bishop asking about dating someone. There's always something that could trigger that in you. First of all, we need to figure out why is this always talked about so much. And as members of the church, we know it is talked about a lot, starting when we're in the youth program. I remember in Young Women's having talks about marriage and preparing for marriage, and I was so young, but I didn't really think about it. I was just like, oh, one day, that's gonna be awesome. And it's just like this fantasy that's super exciting. But as you get older, in the age ranges of 18 to 30 especially, you start to really think about this more because you are in that age where now is the time to make that decision. Now is the time to think about it seriously. And if you don't have a testimony of marriage and the importance of it, then it can really consume your thoughts in a negative way, where we feel this pressure, we get mad at leaders for talking about it in church. It's super important for us to realize why it's so talked about and why we need to get married. As members of the church, we know that family and marriage, temple marriage to be exact, is so important. And God has designed our life to be that way. He wants us to get married in the temple and have an eternal companion. We believe in making sacred covenants with our Heavenly Father. And in the gospel, the way we progress is acting on our faith and making these covenants. So we know that marriage is so important because it's a covenant we make with God to progress in the gospel. And to me, knowing how important and sacred that marriage is to God really helps me understand why it's so important for me to get married. And our leaders try to help us realize that, although I know some of them go a little overboard and can do the opposite effect and make us not want to get married. The thing we need to understand is if we have a testimony of marriage and we know it's what God wants us to do and we're not putting it off for any selfish reasons, then we should not be feeling pressure because of what someone else said or what our friends are doing, or just because we are in this age range. There should not be any pressure. God doesn't want it to become this heavy burden on us. He wants us to be excited for marriage and wanting to make that covenant with our best friend, the best possible person for us. As I thought more about this, I felt like that pressure of getting married can also lead to a whole nother pressure of finding the one. I feel like in the church especially, it is so focused on getting married that that's all we're thinking when we're dating. We're thinking, is he the one? Is she the one? Do I see something further? Which is great. But if you become so focused on the marriage, you can miss the full experience and process of falling in love and committing yourself to each other. It's not bad to think that way, to an extent, but you're also rushing into marriage when you have that mindset of marriage is just the goal. I'm at that age where I need to be married, so let's go find someone. We need to start enjoying the process of dating and finding our eternal companion more. Like, it's so important to have that foundation and that love and commitment to each other, especially in the church when we're making a covenant with each other, with God, forever, to be committed to each other. You need to make sure that you do not do this out of guilt, out of pressure, out of any other motivation than love. There's even the pressure of, well, marriage is forever. Like, how am I supposed to make sure that he's the one for me? Do not focus on the forever aspect, because that will come naturally. You will want to be with your significant other forever if you're truly in love with them. Also, it's a huge joke in the church that people rush into marriage because they want to have sex. And unfortunately, in a lot of cases, this is actually pretty true. And it's sad to say, but even when we were getting married, people were like, "Oh, lucky you get to go have sex now." And I'm like, there's so much more to this day than being able to have sex. So if this is a motivation to you in any way, whether you love your significant other or not, do not get married. That is all you're going to get out of that day of making those covenants is, yay, I get to go have sex. Like, no, like, that should not, it's okay to be excited, okay? But don't let that be the reason you're getting married with someone, or even the reason you're getting married sooner because you're afraid of messing up or anything like that. So I hope what you get out of this video is that as long as you know it's important to God and have a testimony of marriage, you're not obsessing over the idea of getting married or just, I have to get married, and you aren't putting off marriage for selfish reasons, then you should not feel pressure from anybody, and you are doing the right thing. God is proud of you, and the only thing that matters is what your Heavenly Father thinks. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this video helped in any way. Please leave a comment or a message on Instagram if you have any ideas of topics you want me to share. And if you want to come be in my video and come to my little studio and have a little interview or talk about a topic with me, I would love to hear more views and other people's opinions. So please let me know about that as well. Thank you so much for watching and stay tuned for more videos.